Hi students, I welcome to all of you to this session of refrigeration and air conditioning. Dear students, you know that we were discussing the vapor compression reference system. This is your lecture number 11. So last 10 lecture has been uploaded in the YouTube channel. If you haven't seen that lecture, please see that lecture, because this is the continuation of the previous lecture. Last class we have discussed about the condition of refrigerant after compression. That means when the refrigerant is compressed in the compressor, then after that, whether it is your wet condition or dry condition or superheated condition, based on that how you can calculate the particular enthalpy that was discussed earlier. Before coming to the discussion, let us say that admission is open for 2020 in mechanical engineering department. If you want to join, you can contact this number and the email ID and all this it is given, or you can contact to me. This is my phone number, my email ID. You can WhatsApp me for any kind of query related to admission and the subject. My YouTube channel DM Study Center, you can subscribe this channel for getting all the videos. Near about 125 plus video has been uploaded. Okay, video lecture. So please see that lecture. Myself Dhiraj Mondal, Assistant Professor, JS College of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering Department. Vapor compression reference system. You know, last class we discussed the simple vapor compression reference system, how it is operating. Okay. And merit, demerit, function of different parts. Then when the simple vapor compression reference system on temperature entropy diagram, when the vapor is dry and saturated at the end of the compression. So this is the condition. That means in the numerical it will be asked when it is at the outlet or after the compression, the vapor is dry and saturated. So that time it will lie, the 0.3 will lie in the saturated vapor line. Okay, so these are the condition which you have to know. This is the condition for superheated. After compression you will see that it is coming some superheated zone, so only steam, superheated temperature steam will be there, and this is your sensible heat, 3.3 cp delta t, mcp delta t. Okay, so how to calculate the is enthalpy that I have discussed last class. This is the condition for wet after compression, when the vapor is wet. So this is the condition, it is not touching to the saturated vapor line. Then the condition COP, how we have to calculate that also discussed. Pressure enthalpy diagram or pressure enthalpy chart also discussed little bit, and also this is the pH diagram. Already I have told you. Now today we will be discussing about the factors affecting the performance of a simple vapor compression reference system. That means a vapor compression reference system, already I have told you, it is consisting of mainly four devices: one evaporator, one compressor, one condenser, one expansion valve. So in the evaporator, Q2 amount of heat is added from the surrounding. Now the whatever the refrigerant is present here, liquid refrigerant, that liquid refrigerant is taking some latent heat from the system. Then at the outlet of the evaporator, what we are getting, low temperature, low pressure vapor refrigerant, it is coming to the compressor, where WC amount of work is given by the help of some electric power. Okay, and at the outlet what we are getting, high temperature, high pressure vapor refrigerant, or you may say superheated refrigerant. Now it is coming to the condenser, where it is nothing but heat exchanger, where Q1 amount of heat is released or it is rejected to the surrounding. And at the outlet what we are getting, high pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant, and it is expanded in the expansion valve isenthalpically. Okay, so isenthalpic process, you know, the isenthalpic process is there, that means enthalpy remain unchanged here, and at the outlet of the expansion valve we are getting low temperature, low pressure liquid represent, which is our desired motto. And again it is coming to the evaporator section, then again it is in taking some heat content, changing its phase, and again it is coming to the compressor. This is how the particular process is going on. So 1, 2, 3, 4, this is your process. Now if I want to plot this here in this portion, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, so this is your pH diagram. Okay, 4 to 1 isenthalpic process, I have told you, so that is why this enthalpy remain unchanged here. Then here 1 to 2 is your evaporator, 2 to 3 is your compressor, 3 to 4 is your condenser. Now what our discussion? Our discussion is based on the effect of or factor affecting the performance of the simple vapor reference system. So according to the diagram, what is the COP? COP is equal to refrigeration effect, that is your H2 minus H1 by H3 minus H2 by working. Okay. But here basically it is told that suction pressure, what is the function of suction pressure? To raise or to minimize the COP. So we have to discuss here, if I am just changing the pressure, suction pressure, then what will happen? So let us consider 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the process. Original initial process. Okay. So in the initial process, what we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 to 2 is your evaporation. 2 to 3 is your compression. 4 to 1 is your condensation. And 3 to 4 is your condensation. 4 to 1 is your expansion. Clear? Now what I have done, just I have minimized the pressure, suction pressure. So effect of suction pressure, what will happen? The effect of decrease in suction pressure in this diagram, we will see that this one position one will be replaced by one dash. If I am replacing the pressure, then 1 to 2 dash, 2 to 3 dash, 3 to 4, 4 to 1 dash. So this is the diagram after changing the pressure, after minimizing the suction pressure. Why I have told suction? Because in the evaporator, suction basically suction is taking place here. Basically what happened? That means here basically the pressure is minimizing suction pressure is minimizing. So what will happen? The COP, new COP will be getting. So new COP will be, desired effect is equal to H2 dash minus H1 dash by H3 dash minus H2 dash. Now can you see, that means this is the heat extracted initially, but final heat extraction, you will see final heat extraction is what? Final heat extraction is equal to, this is your final heat extraction. That means this amount of heat extraction is basically, it is neglected if I am just minimizing the pressure. Am I right? So that is why initially it is the COP and final COP is this, and ultimately if I am just simplifying this equation, you will see that this amount of heat is basically is not releasing it, not it is unable to extract this amount of heat from the system. So we can say that actually COP is equal to desired effect by work input, or Q2 by WC. So Q2, amount of Q2 is minimizing, so that we will see that COP of the refrigerant and COP of the system, vapor compression reference system, will be in minimizing order. Okay, that means it will minimized. Okay, So according that means in this diagram we can easily say the refrigeration effect is decreased and work input is increased, because you know that this is the work input 2 to 3 2 dash to 3 dash, it is traveling more area it is traveling. So ultimately you will see that compressor work will increase, refrigeration effect is decreasing. So as a result, what we will see, that the COP, the coefficient of performance of the particular vapor compression reference system, will minimize, okay, will decrease, clear? So this is the effect. So in your in the MCQ question or in GATE exam, it will ask that what if suction pressure is minimizing, if I am minimizing the suction pressure in the evaporator section, then what will happen? COP will decrease, COP will increase, remain unchanged, none of the above. So the answer COP will be decreased. So what we have to say here, to get COP, maximum COP, the suction pressure should be as high as possible, and delivery pressure should be as low as possible. If delivery pressure is low, then the compressor work will be low, and the suction pressure is high, then the refrigeration effect will be high. Okay, so this is the condition for suction pressure. Okay, so to get maximum COP, you have to increase the suction pressure, that's all. Next, effect of delivery pressure. So what is the effect delivery pressure that we have to determine here? So basically, let us consider the initially the continuous line here. You can see 1 2 3 4, this is the continuous line. So this is the initial position. Now what I am going to do, I will just increase the delivery pressure. So if I am increasing the delivery pressure, so what will happen that in this in the COP? So first of all, let us see, COP is equal to, we know that H2 minus H1 by H3 minus H2. Okay, so this is the COP initially, but the final COP, what I have done, I am increasing the suction delivery pressure. So 3 dot will be replaced by 3 will be replaced by 3 dot, and 4 will be replaced by 4 dot, and this is the 1 will be replaced by 1 dot. Okay, so in this diagram here, in this diagram you can see, this is the diagram, pH diagram. So in this diagram you can easily understand that what happened. Basically, in the when the delivery pressure is increased, so we will see that the refrigeration effect, initially this was your refrigeration effect, but right now the refrigeration effect, what we are getting, this is your refrigeration effect. So I can say that this mass refrigeration effect, this mass refrigeration effect is minimized or decreasing. Okay, so COP is equal to Q2 by WC. So refrigeration effect will be minimum in the final if I'm delivering pressure, I'm increasing the delivery pressure. Now you can easily say that compressor work is required more than the initial stage, because this amount of compressor work is required more. Okay, so you will see that the area will be more, area under the PV diagram or whatever, PH diagram with the area, you will see that it is more. So here basically compressor work is increasing, mean depression effect is decreasing. So as a result from this equation, we can easily say that COP will be in minimizing order. So to get maximum COP, the delivery pressure should be as low as possible. Am I right? So I hope it is clear. So basically I can say that if the delivery pressure is increased, the COP will be decreased in order. Okay, so this is the condition for the effect of delivery pressure. Am I right? Now if it is clear, then come to the next point, number 3, effect of superheating. So the question will ask, what is the effect of suction, suction pressure, delivery pressure, superheating, subcooling in the VCRS? With neat sketch you have to explain. Okay, so superheating, that means here basically this is 1 2 3 4, again 1 2 3 4, this is the initial condition. Now I'm increasing the temperature, that means after compressor you will see that this is the 3 point, but here the 3 point, the heating, we are just increasing the temperature. So what will happen? So that means the effect of superheating is to increase the refrigeration effect, but this increase also the compressor work. So that is why you will see that this is the initial refrigeration effect and this is the final refrigeration effect. Am I right? So this amount of refrigeration effect is increased, even though we will see that this amount of work, compressor work, is also increased. Okay, this amount of compressor work is also increased. So as a result, we will see that the compressor work which is required is more, that means compared to the refrigeration effect, the compressor work which is required is more than the refrigeration effect. So that as a result, we can say the COP will be minimized. Okay, so this is the condition for superheating. That means I can easily say that the refrigeration effect is increasing, but at the same time the compressor work also increasing. Okay, next point, number 4, very very important. This is the exceptional condition. In point number 4, you will see if I am subcooling the liquid, whatever the liquid coming out from the condenser, if I am subcooling, so 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the initial condition. And final condition is your 1.2.2.3.4.4. Okay. So this is the final condition. So from the diagram, you can see initially this is the refrigeration effect. And final refrigeration effect is, this one is your final refrigeration effect. So this amount of refrigeration effect is added, but the same compression you can see same compressor work is needed, but here it is coming into the subcooling region. So as a result, we can say this is the only option to increase the efficiency. You have to subcool the particular liquid, that means after releasing or after coming out from the condenser, whatever the refrigerant we are getting, high pressure liquid refrigerant, that has to be subcooled by the help of some water cooling process or any other methodology, so that the efficiency of the vapor compression refrigeration system will increase. Okay, so what are the method of subcooling? Inserting a special coil between the condenser and the expansion valve. You can insert a special coil like copper coil and all this, condenser and expansion, between condenser and expansion valve, circulating greater quantity of cooling water through the condenser. Okay, higher quantity of water, cooling water, you can circulate from the, there means from the surface of the refrigerant using water cooler than main circulating water. Also you can use water cooler. Okay, so these are the condition, four condition. So again I am telling you, and again one more condition there is there, effect of suction temperature and condenser temperature. That means you know that efficiency or COP is equal to COP, you can write COP. COP is equal to what? Q2 by Q1 minus Q2. Or in thermodynamic temperature scale, we can say that T1 minus T2. So to get maximum COP, temperature T2 should be as high as possible and T1 should be as low as possible. Why I am telling this? Because let us consider 100 is your T1 and 50 is your T2, or 25 is your T2. So 25 by 100 minus 25 is equal to what? 1/3, that is your 0.33, na? But if I am increasing the temperature T2, let us consider new temperature. So what I have got? 1/3, that is your 0.33. Now if I am increasing the temperature, T2 is 50. So 50 by 100 minus 50. So it is equal to 50 by 50. That is equal to 1. So 1 is greater than 1/3. So if you want to increase the COP of a refrigeration system like your vapor compression refrigeration system, then the temperature in the evaporator section should be as high as possible, and condenser temperature or the T1 should be as low as possible. Clear? So this is the required condition to maximize the COP. Clear? For subcooling, the efficiency is increasing, you know. For superheating, the efficiency, the refrigeration effect is increasing, but as the work required is more, then that is why the COP will be in decrease order. If I am increasing the delivery pressure, again COP is decreasing because refrigeration effect is decreasing and compressor work is increasing. If I am changing the suction pressure, if I am decreasing the suction pressure, then again COP is in decreasing order and work done will be increased. So this is the effect. This is the effect factor affecting the performance of the simple vapor compression reference system. I hope it is clear. Next, come to the actual vapor compression reference system. You know, the actual vapor compression reference cycle differs from the theoretical cycle in several ways because there are some reason behind it. Okay. So what are those reason? We can say this is your TPS diagram of actual vapor compression reference system. In the diagram you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here basically the process, you can see the reason why it is differing. The actual vapor compression cycle differs from the theoretical cycle in several ways because of the some reason. What are the reason? Reason number one is your frequently the liquid refrigerant is subcooled before it is allowed to enter the expansion valve. Okay, this is the expansion valve. So before expansion valve, it is allowed for subcooled. Okay. So the liquid refrigerant is subcooled before it is allowed to enter the expansion valve, and usually the gas leaving the evaporator is superheated. From the evaporator, when the gas is leaving, it is superheated in this portion. Okay, it is basically superheated a few degree before it enters the compressor. Okay, this superheating may occur as a result of the type of expansion valve used or through a pickup of heat in the suction line between the evaporator and compressor. So you can see after superheating the particular compression is taking place. Now what happened? Compression basically, although usually assumed to be isentropic, may actually proved to be neither isentropic nor polytropic. We are assuming that compression is taking place isentropically, but even though it is not like this, this line is not acceptable. Basically, it is not polytropic, neither polytropic nor isentropic. Okay, so this is the actual condition. Now both the compressor suction and discharge valve are actuated by pressure difference, and this process requires the actual suction pressure inside the compressor to be slightly below that of the evaporator and the discharge pressure to be above the condenser. I hope it is clear. Next point number four, we can say that the isentropic compression assumes no transfer of heat. You know that isentropic compression means no transfer of heat between the refrigerant and the cylinder wall. Yet we can see that the cylinder wall are hotter than the incoming gas from the evaporator and cooler than the compressed gas discharged to be condenser. And last point I would like to mention, that pressure drop in long suction liquid line, and the pressure drop here, basically the pressure drop in the long suction liquid line piping and any vertical difference is heat created by locating the evaporator and condenser at different elevation. So you will see that the pressure difference, this is your PC, delivery pressure, and this is the compressor pressure. There is a small pressure difference. This is your evaporator pressure and suction pressure and evaporator pressure. So there is some pressure difference, you can see. So this is all about the actual vapor compression reference system. I hope it is clear, and it is all whatever what I have discussed, that is written here. Okay, you can go through it so that it will be more clear. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Now come to the next slide, that is your volumetric efficiency. What do you mean by volumetric efficiency? Volumetric efficiency is the ratio of actual volume by swept volume. Now the question is coming, what is actual volume? Basically, when in the PV diagram, we will see that PV diagram 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. So this is your actual volume. This is your actual volume VA. And what is the swept volume? This total is your swept volume up to this mass. So in this diagram, you can see this is the actual volume. This is your actual volume VA. And this is swept volume. Now, if I want to mention, that means how it is, this is a cylinder like this, and this is a piston, and this piston is moving up, moving down. Okay, reciprocating motion is taking place. Now it is coming up to this mass. So what happened, this is your TDC, and let us consider this is your BDC. What is TDC stands for? TDC stands for top dead center, BDC is your bottom dead center. Now when the piston is traveling from TDC to BDC, okay, total this is your stroke length. Okay, now you see in this diagram, this is called stroke length L, denoted by L, and L is equal to 2R, where R is the crank radius. Clear? Now see here, this is the piston displacement. So whatever TDC to BDC it is displacing, that is your swept volume. This is the clearance volume, we can see. This one is your clearance volume, because we can't reach up to the top portion of the cylinder because there is some valve and all this. So that is why this is the swept volume, how much piston displacement are there and actually how much air is sucked. That is your actual volume. So this actual volume by swept volume ratio is called your volumetric efficiency. Next class we will be discussing about the volumetric efficiency. What is clearance ratio? What is volumetric efficiency? Okay, and all these will be discussed. What is total volumetric efficiency? Mathematical analysis of vapor compression reference system will be discussed. Some related numerical will be discussed. Okay, so I hope it is clear today up to this. Any kind of inquiry, you can any kind of query related to admission, you can call here, or this is my phone number, you can WhatsApp me. Okay, any kind of query related to mechanical engineering department, you can ask me. Myself Dheeraj Mondal. All the video lecture will be uploaded in the DMA study center. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get everyday notification. And the Telegram channel you can see for PDF. If you want to get this PDF, then you can join me in this Telegram channel. Okay, DM Study Center official. Okay, so today up to this. Thank you for listening. Jai.